students, as in previous video, I continued the chapter, the last child, in which we studied how a child goes to the fair with his parents, and on his way he was attracted to see butterflies, toys and many more. Now he has reached the fair. What he had seen in the fair, let's see all of you. Open your book, all of you, and see page number 3, above side C, second paragraph. A sweet meat seller hawked. Hawked here spoke. Here hawked spoke. A sweet meat seller was speaking by calling the name of different sweets: gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebi. At the corner of the entrance and a crowd pressed round the counter, at the foot of an architecture of many colored sweets. Now the boy was attracted to see the different type of sweets. Barfi was more favorite for him, but he knew that his father and mother would not purchase for him. See, a sweet meat seller hawked gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebi at the corner of the entrance, and a crowd pressed around his counter at the foot of an architecture of many colored sweets decorated with leaves of silver and gold. The child stared open eyed and his mouth watered for the barfi that was his favorite treat. Now when the child saw sweet, he wanted to eat barfi. I want that barfi, he slowly murmured, and slowly he said, I want that barfi, he said. But he half knew as he begged that his plea would not be heeded because his parents would say he was greedy. So without waiting for answer, he moved on. But though the child wanted to eat barfi, but he knew that his parents would not purchase for him. So he again went forward. A flop when he went into the fair, at the next place what he had seen, let's see. A flower seller was selling a garland of gulmohar, a garland of gulmohar he was calling. The child seemed irresistibly drawn. He went towards the basket where the flowers lay heaped and half murmured, I want that garland. The child reached near the flower seller and he saw the garland. He wanted to have one of the garland, but he well knew that his parents would refuse to buy those flowers because they would say that they were cheap. But he knew that his parents would not purchase the flower and garland. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. At the place where sweets were sold, he was attracted. He could not get barfi. And further, when he saw flower seller, he wanted to take garland, but he knew that his parents would not purchase, so he went on. Further, what happened, let's see. A man stood holding a pole with yellow, red, green and purple balloons flying from it. A balloon seller was there, selling balloon. The child was simply carried away by the rainbow glory of their silken color, and he was filled with an overwhelming desire to possess them all. But he well knew his parents would never buy him the balloon because they would say he is too old to play with such twice, so he walked on further. He wanted to purchase, the child wanted to purchase different balloons, but he knew that his parents would not purchase and they would think that he was too young to play balloons. So he went forward. Further, let's see. A snake charmer stood playing a flute to a snake, which coiled itself in a basket, its head raised in a graceful bend like the neck of a swan, while the music stole into the individual ear like the gentle rippling of an individual waterfall. The child went towards the snake charmer, but knowing his parents had forbidden him to hear such coarse music as the snake charmer played, he proceeded farther. Further, when he was moving, he saw that there was a snake charmer showing the performance of a snake, and he was playing a flute, but he could not stay there because he knew that his parents would call him. There was a roundabout in full swing. Roundabout, there was a swing. Men, women and children carried away in a whirlpool, whirling motion, shrieked and cried with dizzy laughter. The child watched them intently, and then he made a bold request. "I want to go on the roundabout, please, father, mother." When he saw the roundabout, people were swinging on it, then he requested one time to his father and mother to go on the roundabout, but they did not listen. The next page. There was no reply. He turned to look at his parents. They were not there. Ahead of him, he turned to look. On either side, they were not there. He looked behind. There was no sign of them. Students, the problem came when the child was looking at the roundabout and he wanted to go on it, and when he requested his parents that he wanted to go on the roundabout and he moved back, he found that there were no father and mother. It was the time when he was lost in the fair, and he began to search his parents in the fair, but he could not find it. Further, students, what happened, I will teach you in next video. Thank you.